It's Metalwargod here, and I have a video mail update for you. Some stuff I've picked up over the last couple weeks of New Year, and I want to wish or say Happy New Year to everybody out there. Of course, we're already halfway through January, so anyway, first I'm going to show you some stuff that I have gotten over the last couple weeks, right after the New Year, and I'm going to start off with band called Them. I had the CD, and when I knew they were gonna, when the vinyl was coming out, I ordered two of these, and one is going in a trade, which is already gone. So anyway, this is their album Sweet Hollow, and very, very killer band. Of course, they're on the Empire Records, and nice thing about this is when they sent these because two of them, when I did order the vinyl, they had sent me two CDs and said, so I emailed them back a couple times and told them that I paid for the vinyl and I could send the CDs back if they wanted. So all I had to do was take a picture of the CDs I got, and they sent out the vinyl of this, two of them I ordered. And was surprised because in addition, they sent me some other stuff. I got a signed poster by all members of the band. And I had four different posters I got of them as well. But that was in a different order when I got the CDs, but it was only signed by one member. This particular poster I got is signed by all four members. In addition, I got a 12 by 12, which is part of the box set. And they sent me this, and this is signed by the band, Empire Records. And also in that package, I got this CD, which is their tour edition CD, three songs. The tour edition CD is Them, Fear Them, and it has Forever Burns, Dead at Night, and Blood from Blood, which is very cool. So they sent me that, which is very nice. And like I say, I got the poster, I got four postcards, and I also got a patch. I was not expecting any of that except the two albums. And you know, it's very nice that bands do that, you know, in addition to keep the CDs. So I'm giving the CDs away on my radio show on Wednesday, so it isn't like I'm gonna hoard them, which I never do. I always spread it, and so that's what I'm gonna do with the CDs. So anyway, here's Them. Very nice package. Up next, a band that I heard on one of our DJ's radio show. I knew of the band, but I did not have any music from the band. I talked to one of the members that was in this band, who happened to be in Primal Fear, and I'm talking about Thunderhead and Under the Eight Ball, or Beyond the Eight Ball, excuse me, which is this album here. And of course, Henny Walters is in the band, and Henny is right here. So I got this. This is from 1989. So I was happy to get this and looking forward to listening to this. Next, I got another addition to the Saxon collection, which is Crusader. And let's see, this I believe came out in 1984. This is on the Carrere Records label. And this was a Discogs buy. I think I paid $8 for this. And so anyway, I'm close to having every album on vinyl from Crusader. I'm missing a couple. And this came last week, and I had ordered some other Saxon on vinyl, and I was waiting for it. And this actually came, and I did have this. It was a different label. I can't think of the label, but this is actually a re-release of this album. This first came out in 1991, and this came, re-release came out in 2013, and it is on Demon Records. I've gotten 7 or 8 of them on the Demon Records. Some that have never been released on vinyl, like Metalhead, Unleash the Beast, The Inner Sanctum, Lionheart, a couple other ones too, but this one I did not have, so I picked this one up. And most of these are fairly decent price, $15. I mean, you can't go wrong with $15. So anyway, that was a nice addition. And then I got my first pickup of 2017, and I'm talking about the new Gravedigger, Healed by Metal, on Napalm Records. This is a limited gold edition, and it has 12 tracks, 2 bonus tracks. I believe the CD has regular 10 tracks, unless they have a limited edition CD, which I do not know. I know the vinyl has 2 extra tracks, but brand new Gravedigger, very good album. Is it as good as their last one? Not quite, but still, Gravedigger is Gravedigger, and they never fail to put out a good album. A lot of people are turned off by the vocals, but I think that's what makes the band so unique, are the vocals. Like Chris Bottineau. So anyway, those are stuff that I had opened prior to the video last week. Now I got stuff that I have. I did already unseal these edges, so anyway, here's the first one. And this is an album that I pre-ordered back in November. And they said it was shipped around the middle of December, and I kept waiting. Sent them emails, they were gonna check on it, I sent them the second email, and I told them I never got it. Then that was probably about a week, probably the first week in January. So they refunded my money, and then I went online over to Amazon, and I found this was going for sale, and actually got it cheaper. I'm talking about the band Hammer King, and their new album from 2016, King is Rising. Great, great band out of France. I believe this is their third album. Just a traditional heavy metal band. Never go wrong with these guys. These guys put out fantastic heavy metal. It's on the Cruz del Sur label. So definitely the label caters to more of the traditional style of heavy metal. And anyway, here is Hammer King with The King is Rising. So I was happy to get that. This one probably would have made my 2016 list had it came in 2016. As a result, it came today, and it did not make the list. All right, another album that I've already cut. Sometimes I like to cut these a little bit earlier. It just makes it easier. And wow, and I'm glad. This is a pre-order as well. And this is number 5 in Rocks Records Underground series, Saint and the Hellblade. I have this on CD, and different cover as far as this goes, and it's limited to 150, and I have number 47. So I was happy to get this, my second 2017 purchase, so very nice. Got a couple left, and anyway, another package, and this is getting closer to completing my collection, and I'm talking about Saxon Denim and Leather, one of their early classic albums from 1981. This is on the Carrere Records label. Carrere, of course, is a French label. This is actually a promo, gold stamp promo here. But I mean, the cover's got a little ring wear up here, but all in all, I mean, the album's in very good shape, or the cover, I should say, is in very good shape. The album is in really, really almost pristine shape. So whoever had this really kept good care of it. And then it comes in the record protector, vinyl, or the static cling free, which is very nice. So nice addition to the, I think I'm missing like two albums on vinyl from Saxon. So I think I'm missing the self-titled one, and I think I'm missing Wheels of Steel. But anyway, this gets me closer. And last, one more album here. And Canadian band. A lot of good Canadian music that I did not get a chance to hear back in the 70s, and this is from the 70s. The band is called Hellfield. This album came out in 1978, just classic 70s hard rock. From Canada, this is a, I believe this is a Canadian pressing, if I'm not mistaken. Check here. Yes, this is a Canadian pressing. And of all the albums I bought back in the 70s, I never came across this at all. So this is actually a Discogs buy. I think I paid $7 for this. They have two albums out. This is their self-titled from 78, and they have one that came out in 1979. So yeah, good stuff there. So anyway, that's what I've gotten so far in 2017. I did get a bunch of Saxon, but I showed them in a different video. But anyway, just leave a comment below in the box, and got anything to say, just let me know. Anyway, that's all I have for this edition of Metalwargod's video mail update, and I'll see you next time. Take care, everybody.